Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jimmy Wallington. Due to the illness of Miss Joan Crawford, our adaptation of The Damned Don't Cry, scheduled for this evening, has been postponed.
Screen Directors Playhouse stars Marlena Dietrich, John Lund, Lucille Ball. Production, A Foreign Affair. Director, Billy Wilder.
This is the Screen Directors Playhouse, the Thursday night feature on NBC's All-Star Festival of Comedy, Music, Mystery, and Drama. Brought to you by Chesterfield, the cigarette that has for you mildness with no unpleasant aftertaste. The cigarette that brings you Bing Crosby and Bob Hope. By the makers of Anison for fast relief from the pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. And by RCA Victor, world leader in radio, first in recorded music, first in television. Tonight, the Screen Directors Playhouse is pleased to present the sound of love and laughter. Here are Lucille Ball, Marlena Dietrich, and John Lund, starring in our adaptation of an adventure and comedy named A Foreign Affair. And now, Mr. Crosby, if you please.
Now here's Chesterfield's answer to Cyrano de Bergerac, Bob Hope.
I'd top you easy, Dad, but we only have a minute here to sell Chesterfield.
Okay, well, let's get to it.
Better tasting Chesterfield is the only cigarette that combines for you mildness with no unpleasant aftertaste.
The mildness is a cinch to prove. You just make the Chesterfield mildness test. You know, open a pack and enjoy that milder aroma. Then smoke them, and you'll know that Chesterfields are mild.
And Chesterfield leaves no unpleasant aftertaste. That fact has been confirmed by the country's first and only cigarette taste panel.
So make our cigarette your cigarette. The reasons go together like this.
Chesterfield, Chesterfield, always takes first place. That milder, mild tobacco never leaves an aftertaste.
Oh ho, open a pack and give them a smell.
Then you'll smoke them.
Now the first act of A Foreign Affair, starring John Lund and Marlena Dietrich in their original roles of Captain John Pringle and Erica von Schluto, and Lucille Ball as Phoebe Frost. In all the world, there is only one thing more awesome than a visiting congressman, and that is a visiting congresswoman. With this, we give you Miss Phoebe Frost, bound for Berlin aboard an American transport plane. Prim Miss Phoebe Frost, immersed in the note she is carefully writing into a prim black book, which she holds primly propped on a large cake box.
There are 3 1/4 women for every man in Berlin. Wonder what they do with a quarter of a woman. Probably save her for the quartermaster sergeant.
Congresswoman Frost, we're approaching Berlin.
Yes, Congressman Giffen, I know.
Well, don't you want to see the ruins?
Must I remind the chairman of our committee that this is not a sightseeing tour? We're here to investigate the morale of United States troops.
My, look at that wreckage. What a horrible sight.
Not nearly so horrible as the sight of an American boy fraternizing with a German woman. I've heard of those things. What the American Army needs is more setting up exercises. When we land, I assure you, Congressman, that I shall explore the situation thoroughly. Phoebe Frost is a relentless foe of fraternization.
Colonel Plummer, the honor guard is formed.
Thank you, Captain Pringle.
Company! Hey! Pass!
Lieutenant Lee, you look despondent. You'll have to smile for the congressman.
No, it's these German dames, Pringle.
You mean Trudy? The fireball Fräulein? What happened?
I lost her.
Oh, you ran out of candy bars?
A Russian sergeant came along with a pound of rancid butter.
Oh, you're an amateur, Lee. Now, I wouldn't be afraid of a Russian general with a ton of caviar. Take a look at these. Here, in my pocket.
Nylons. Where'd you get them?
Black market. For Erica.
Yeah.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.